내가 요새?
예.
또 말해, 또 말해, 또 말해.
됐어. Please tell us something about yourself.
My name is Nilotpal Sekia. I come from Nagaon district. And I have done my graduation from Tezpur Central University and post-graduation from IIT Hyderabad in Electronics and Communication. And presently I'm working in DRDO as a scientist in Hyderabad. And my hobbies are to do coding and artificial intelligence.
Why did you choose an institution like DRDO? Topmost organization in India and come to join civil services?
Yes sir, DRDO is a reputed institute, but what I have found that I am confined to only the technical domain, but I want to contribute in diverse areas also. So in that regard, I found civil service as a dynamic job. It gives diverse opportunities where I can use my capacities and knowledge.
Do you think we need more scientists, because India is lagging behind in pure science research?
Yes sir, we definitely require scientists for doing the research and R&D activities, and definitely the other sectors are also required, like for administrative services also it is required, sir.
Why India is still importing a lot of electronics goods, and why are we not being able to cope up with the rest of the world?
Yes ma'am, the main, we are also doing the electronic manufacturing, but that is in the assembly line. So in electronics, the value addition in the assembly stage is very less, because the main R&D is in the production of the processors or the production of the cameras, digital cameras. But why India is lagging, the main thing is that we don't have foundries. Over the world, there are 150 commercial foundries, but in India, we don't have a single foundry as of now, because the cost of setting up a foundry is very high. It is in the tune of around $50 billion.
So what should we be doing?
Yes. In the recent electronics policy also, the vision is to make India as a hub for electronic manufacturing equipments. And for that, if we see the overall, the benefit of setting up a foundry, in the long term it's going to be beneficial, though the investment cost is very high. So I think we should set up a foundry, and also as the vision goes, like make in India, and to make India as a manufacturing hub, we should encourage more electronic production in our country.
What if you are selected in the taxation department as inspector of taxes, will you still join the service?
Yes sir, I'll still join the service, because then I can come to Assam, and again I'll prepare for the next year.
But then the government will be spending a lot of money on your training. So if you leave the job after your training, there will be a lot of loss. It will be a big loss for the exchequer.
Yes sir, if you see in the short term, the loss will be there. But if you see the long term perspective, the knowledge that I'll gain as a tax officer, so it will be helpful in the civil administration itself, because all are connected. So the knowledge will add value to my service in as a civil servant also.
What are your hobbies?
My hobbies are to do coding and things related to artificial intelligence.
How can artificial intelligence help in increasing safety of women?
Yes ma'am, artificial intelligence can be useful for because the for safety of the women, the thing is we should predict. The prediction of the crime is very essential. Before the crime occurs, using artificial intelligence, we can analyze the CCTV footages. So based on that, we can identify the criminal or what pattern of crimes are occurring in the society. So accordingly, we can establish the safety measures.
Do you think we have ample or good laws for cybersecurity in India?
Yeah, we have laws for cybersecurity, for hacking and phishing. Nowadays, a lot of cyber attack is occurring, and that is going to be a new, so we call it cyber warfare. So that to counter those attacks, we have the laws, ma'am.
Can you name some of them?
Presently, I can't recall, ma'am, exactly.
Can you tell us some major problems that that you have been observing in Naugaon district?
In Naugaon district, problems are like we don't have much employment opportunities as of now. And second thing will be Naugaon district is not having any direct air connectivity.
How will you reduce the employment problem? How will you address the employment problem once you are posted as, you know, deputy commissioner of Naugaon?
So Naugaon has a lot of fertile lands. So what I think opportunities in the agriculture sector can be utilized, because though we have a lot of schemes, the people are not aware of it. So my first priority will be to make them aware of the recent the schemes that government has launched, so how they can get most benefit out of it. And then I'll try to set up some training also, skill training for the persons.
Kaandulat
moi jukan kora nasilu.
Kyo kora nasilu apni?
Moi kora nasilu karon moi jehetu ejon government official, by CCS rules I am not supposed to participate in such.
এনে আপনি সাপোর্ট কৰেনে মনৰ ভিতৰৰ পৰা?
ইয়াতে পাৰ্সপেক্টিভ দুটা আমাৰ আছে. এটা হ'ল যে ওৱান ইজ দেট দ্য কা হেজ বিন ইমপ্লিমেণ্টেড টু গিভ চাম চিকিউৰিটি টু দ্য পাৰ্চন হু হেভ বিন পাৰ্চিকিউটেড ইন নেবাৰিং কাণ্ট্ৰিজ. চ' ডেফিনেটলি ইটছ এ ৱেলকাম ষ্টেপ অন হিউমেনিটেৰিয়ান গ্ৰাউণ্ডছ. বাট এট দ্য চেম টাইম উই হেভ টু চি আৱাৰ ৰিজনেল ইছ্যুজ অলছ' পাৰ্টিকুলাৰলি ইন এ ষ্টেট লাইক আছাম. Because it's going to be affected in a major way. So we have to ensure the people that although the migration of people will come to Assam, but they will be distributed or proper steps should be taken to assure the people. So I don't support protest as a way. A peaceful protest is fine, but not aggressive ones.
What can you do to boost the tourism industry of Assam? You specifically, considering the background that you have.
Yes, ma'am, Assam has a lot of opportunities for development of tourism. So first of all, I would say we have to ensure the safety and of the state so that the image of the state is good overall India, so that it becomes a preferred destination. Already we are doing some branding like Awesome Assam and other activities we are taking. So secondly, we have to improve the infrastructure like the road connectivity, specialized tourist agents. So and overall the website of the Assam government can be made more interactive so that people can easily access those sites, what is available. So that will be helpful, I think.
Aptitude amar civil servant ejonor kenuka dhoronor hobo lage.
এজন চিভিল চাৰ্ভেণ্ট হাৰ ইণ্টিগ্ৰিটি থাকিব লাগে, ৰেছপনচিবিলিটি হ'ব লাগে, হি শ্বুড বি চিনচিয়াৰ, ডেডিকেটেড, এণ্ড মষ্ট ইম্পৰ্টেণ্টলি হি শ্বুড বি এম্পেথেটিক টু দ্য পিপল অল এৰাউণ্ড. আই থিংক দোজ কোৱালিটিজ আৰ হেল্পফুল.
এম্পেথি আৰু চিম্পেথিৰ মাজত ডিফাৰেন্স আছে নেকি?
ইয়েছ মেম, দেৰ ইজ এ ছাবটাইল ডিফাৰেন্স. লাইক এম্পেথি ইজ লাইক উই ট্ৰাই টু বি ইন দ্য আদাৰ পাৰ্চন শ্বুজ এণ্ড ট্ৰাই টু ফিল what problem he is facing. But sympathy will be like it's more emotional in nature. So as a civil servant, I think empathy is more useful for him.
Thank you.